Hi everyone, the channel Easy Lecture welcomes you. In this video, we are going to discuss how to find the solution of state equation. Before entering into the video, subscribe my channel Easy Lecture. Now let us go for further discussion. The question given here is, the state equation and initial condition vector of a linear time invariant system is given. Determine the solution of state equation. Okay, we have to find the solution of state equation, and in the question, state equation and initial conditions are given. Okay, so this is the state equation and this is the initial condition vector. Okay, how to find the solution of state equation? Okay, the formula to find the solution of state equation is x of t is equal to e power a t into x naught. Okay, while e power a t is the transition matrix, x naught is the initial condition vector. So we have this x naught, but we do not have e power a t. We have to find e power a t. How to find e power a t? To find e power a t, we must know a. Okay, the value of a. So what is it? The value of a can be obtained from this state equation. State equation is given as this derivative of state variable into equal to system matrix multiplied with state variable. Okay, so again, this is system matrix. This is nothing but this A matrix. So we have got A is equal to 1, 0, 1, 1 from this state equation. Okay, next, there is a notation to denote e power a t. E power a t is denoted as pi of t, and pi of t is inverse Laplace transform of pi of s. Okay, and pi of s, there is a relationship which relates pi of s with the system matrix A. It is SI minus A the whole inverse. Okay, now we have to find this. If we find this, we will be able to apply inverse Laplace transform to this matrix to obtain transition matrix e power a t, and that e power a t can be multiplied with initial condition to arrive at the solution of state equation. That is what we are going to do now. Okay, now SI minus A is equal to S into identity matrix 1 0 0 1 minus system matrix A matrix 1 0 1 1. Okay, so SI minus A is equal to S into 1 S minus 1 S minus 1 S into 0 0 minus 0 0 S into 0 0 minus 1 minus 1 S into 1 1 minus 1 S minus 1. Okay, so we have got SI minus A. Now SI minus A inverse can be formed by using this formula, cofactor of SI minus A transpose divided by determinant of SI minus A. Okay, now let us find the determinant of SI minus A. So this is determinant of SI minus A. The determinant of SI minus A is equal to S minus 1 into S minus 1, S minus 1 the whole square, minus of minus 1 into 0, 0, that is equal to S minus 1 the whole square. Right? And cofactor of SI minus A transpose can be easily formed since it is a 2 by 2 matrix. Since SI minus A is a 2 by 2 matrix, we can easily find the cofactor of SI minus A transpose by this manner. We have to write the leading diagonal elements in reverse order. Okay, we have to interchange the leading diagonal elements. Okay, that means, let's say the whole inverse is equal to 1 divided by S minus 1 the whole square into, now we have to write the cofactor of SI minus A transpose. To find that, we have to write the leading diagonal elements in reverse order. So S minus 1, S minus 1. I have interchanged. Since both are same, it doesn't make any change. Then I have to change the sign of the other diagonal element. Okay. So here I have to make the change. I have to change the sign of 0. Even though I change the sign of 0, there won't be any effect. And I have to change the sign of minus 1. It can be written as plus 1. Okay. So this is cofactor of SI minus A transpose. Now we can multiply 1 divided by s minus 1 the whole square with every element inside the matrix to find SI minus A inverse. Okay, so SI minus A inverse is equal to S minus 1 divided by S minus 1 the whole square is 1 by S minus 1. 0 divided by S minus 1 the whole square is 0. S minus 1 the whole square divided, 1 divided by S minus 1 the whole square into 1 is 1 divided by S minus 1 the whole square. S minus 1 divided by S minus 1 the whole square is 1 divided by S minus 1. Okay, so this is nothing but pi of S. Okay, now we have to find e power a t, which is equal to pi of t, which is equal to inverse Laplace transform of pi of s. So we have to apply inverse Laplace transform to every element of pi of s. Okay, inverse Laplace transform of 1 by s minus 1 is e power t, and inverse Laplace transform of 0 is 0. Inverse Laplace transform of 1 divided by s minus 1 the whole square is t into e power t. Inverse Laplace transform of 1 by s minus 1 is e power t. Okay, so we have got e power at. Now the question is to find the solution of state equation. Solution of state equation can be found using this formula: x of t is equal to e power at into x naught. So x of t is equal to e power at, that is e power t 0 t into e power t e power t x naught, it can be taken from the question, 1, 0. So this is equal to e power 8 t, e power t into 1, e power t plus 0 into 0, 0, t into e power t into 1, t into e power t, then e plus e power t into 0, 0. So this is x of t, this is the solution of the given state equation. So in this manner we can easily find the solution of state equation, and we need to know this formula, the formula to find the solution of state equation and the formula to find e power at. With that idea we can easily find the solution of any state equation. Okay, I hope you have understood this problem, and regarding this video you can give your comment in the comment box. Don't forget to subscribe my channel Easy Lecture. Then like this video, share this video, meet you again in another video, and then bye. Thank you.